Hi everyone, welcome to this tutorial. In this video, I'll be covering everything you need to know about setting the custom query parameters for the listing grid widget while working with the Jet Engine plugin. Now we're going to have a look at how the text query for the listing grid works. So you select text query and there you choose the taxonomy that you're going to filter these posts by. So what you can do is to filter it by the default taxonomy, which is categories, tags, but also you can create the custom taxonomies, which I did, and we're going to get to the custom taxonomy a little later, and we're going to start with the categories, which is the default taxonomy. So in the taxonomy, we select categories, and later, what we need to do is to select how we're going to pull out the categories. Actually, the tags from the category taxonomy, right? So we can choose from term ID. So we're going to need to insert the term ID here, and the post will be filtered by the ID of the term. Or we can use the slug of the category, or we can use the name of the category. Actually, each of these three is pretty easy to learn, to get to know. What we're going to do is to go to WordPress dashboard and here say I want to learn the ID, the slug, and the name of the categories that I have here for the default post type. So I go to post categories, here it goes. Usually you can find the taxonomy which is assigned to a certain post type right there in the dropdown once you hover over this post type. So we have opened the categories. And what we have here is the list of the categories that are available for this custom post type. And there we go. Here we have name, slug, and to learn the ID of this post, you simply need to hover over it. And at the left-hand bottom corner, again, you're going to see the link, which says ID equals and the number. And this is actually going to be that ID that you need. So there we go. That's pretty simple to learn the name, the slug, or the ID. So let's go back to the listing grid and let's go with the name actually. And I'm going to type in business. So now what this listing grid is going to do is to pull out all of the posts that have the business category in their list of categories to which they belong. So there you go, you see business, local business is the child's category of the business category, so it's going to also appear in the grid. So it's going to work pretty much the same way with the custom taxonomy. So here it goes. Let me show this to you. Let's remove that. And working with the custom taxonomy or with the default taxonomy, in both cases, you can also use the operators, and I'm going to show it to you in a second. And with the custom taxonomy, it's going to work pretty much the same way. So what I have here is the custom taxonomy, which has only two tags. So let's find it here. So it has one and two. I chose to show it only with the two categories, so it is easier to understand and easier to explain. So what I'm going to do is to type in these two tags, both of them. There we go. And now it is going to display the posts that have either one or another because the operator is set to in. So it is going to look for the post that have at least one of these terms that you have put in here. So if we select not in, the listing grid is going to show only the posts that do not have any of these terms that you have put here in the terms field. So it's going to display all the other posts that do not have these terms. Now and. The operator AND ensures that you see only the posts that have all of the terms that you have typed in here. I've typed two of the terms, two tags, 1 and 2, and it only shows me one post because I have assigned both of them to one post only. Now exist and not exist. Basically, they do pretty much the same thing as the in and not in correspondingly. So exist is somewhere close to in and not in to not exist. So they do pretty much the same thing. And you see that whether you choose exist or in, it's going to display the posts that have either one or another. And if there are more than two, it's going to look for the posts that have at least one of these terms that are typed in here. So basically, that's it for the essentials of the setting tax query parameters.